Hey guys, today I am excited to bring you to a neighborhood right on the border of Summerville. So if you're still looking for great prices, you're looking for a neighborhood you can build and customize your home, right? Not a lot of that anymore. Or maybe you're somebody who's a-okay with a spec home. Today, we're gonna talk about a neighborhood called Homecoming right here in Ravenel. Ravenel is right on the cusp of Summerville. So the schools here are gonna be zoned for your high school, you're gonna be zoned for Ashley Ridge, and then your middle school is gonna be East Edisto, which is in DD2, and then Beach Hill as your elementary school. Now, the one thing I do like about this neighborhood, the builder, True Homes, they not only still do customize and build homes to your requirements, like you wanna do a true to-be-built, pick the lot, pick the house, the floor plan, and then also you get to go ahead and pick what tile goes in there, all that good stuff. It's just not the spec building. But if you're someone who's like,
hey Ryan, I need a home like next week or next month,
they have some phenomenal specs and they're putting stuff in their houses that you are not gonna see in any other builders in Summerville. So I think it's worth your time and opportunity to check out True Homes right here in Ravenel at Homecoming. So again, if you're someone who likes a little bit more yard space, you're gonna get that here. If you're someone who likes hardy plank siding, guess what? You're gonna get that here. Look at these houses behind me. They've got board and batten, we've got shaker, you know, but it's all in that hardy plank. They actually are using brick. I love the bigger windows on these houses. Now, the cons on this neighborhood are going to be, and I wanna be very clear on this, are going to be the surrounding infrastructure. Right now, there is none. And you're gonna see some of the drone shots that I took. You're gonna see where they're starting to clear land for Walmart, for stores, grocery shop, and all that stuff that they need over on this side of town. And they do need it. Not only are we here in Homecoming, but we're very close to Summer's Corner. And so again, you can imagine with all the people relocating here, that's gonna get tough if the smaller grocery stores nearby just get overwhelmed. It's gonna be tough to find things and it's just gonna make life a little bit more frustrating. So I'm excited that they're clearing land, they're actually doing that for this area to make houses here in Homecoming a lot more desirable, and they will be. But the thing is, you're right now getting in on pre all of that. And why that's important, and I tell people this all the time, when I first moved here, there wasn't a whole lot in our neighborhood. There was very little. We had one gas station. Now we have like four or five within a 2 mile radius. So you have to remember, you're getting in before the area blows up. So that's what you want to remember. This area is still very affordable for families and first time home buyers. So if you're someone looking, you need to reach out and let me know. I can tell you all more about Homecoming. Now, let's go tour their models. So this home we're walking into is a Jasper. It's 2452 square feet. I like the more southern appeal to this. You've got the double front porch, which is always nice. You got the very coastal colors, and I love the little peach door. So you've got the front porch here, which is nice. A lot of people like to sit out on their front porch. So as we enter, this would generally be the garage, but they have it obviously set up as a sales office. So you just gotta picture that as like a door to the garage. Right when we walk in, you've got this really great corner office. I love the French doors into the office. Like that's a little angled off the front door. It's just not squared off. Gives it a little character. Definitely a nice size office. When we come in, one of the things you'll notice with True Homes, you can add crown molding. You can really customize these houses. You got the chair walls, all that good stuff. And one of the things too, I'll point out, because this is probably one of my biggest pet peeves with a lot of builders right now, is the size of the islands. Look at the size of this length of this island. This is huge. So you got a big, big island. You've got quartz counters. So one thing I like is True Homes, I've never really found their countertops in another builder's home. And what I mean by that is like, they're using stone and suppliers that you normally just don't see in these other style spec homes or spec builders. You'll notice too, the hardware is fully customizable if you're doing a true to be built. If you're gonna do a spec home, they're gonna spec that home out really well for you, but just keep in mind, it's not something you're gonna be able to make a change on. And then again, natural gas community, love that, love the gourmet cooktop, got the herringbone backsplash. Now this home is 3 bedrooms, 2.5 baths, 2454 square feet. Look at the size of this living room. And I love all the windows. Now before we head upstairs, I wanna show you this. You got this great drop zone right here, little closet. And one of the things I do like is the floors. You got that LVP flooring and then the oak tread stairs with the stand handrail to match. All right, so now we come upstairs here. You've got this nice little, study area for the kids. I think this is important to have in just about any house. If you have kids, great space. All right, decent sized bedroom in here. This makes for a great kids room. They actually do the taller ceilings upstairs here. So you do have 9 foot ceilings with 8 foot doorways. So I really, really like that. They don't just take the 9 and drop it down to an 8. Okay, another full bathroom here. And then our next bedroom, which is a really great size and has a ton of windows. So the last bedroom had 1 window, this has 3. And I like that they went with these kind of creative, more designer, narrow windows. So realistically, you probably couldn't fit a full-size window there, nice closet. But what they did was they used kind of thinner windows and did a kind of a really cool custom area. So you've got windows on each side. Now last year, I had my clients from Buffalo who relocated. They relocated from Lancaster, or Lockport, excuse me. And one of the neat things is they actually purchased this floor plan. And they have one of the cool tropical colors. This is one thing I really like about True Homes. I've mentioned this in other videos, but the builders who bring the HVAC system from the attic and they bring it down into here, you actually have the system working in an air-conditioned environment as opposed to the system working in the attic, which is sometimes 108, 115 in the summer. So if you're someone who's, hey, I wanna make sure we have the most energy efficient home, that right there is gonna add an element of home efficiency and energy efficiency that you're not gonna find in a lot of other builders. All right, on to the master. Beautiful master. Look at this. I love, love, love the sitting area. Here's my pet peeve with most masters now. My parents in their master bedroom in a home that I grew up in, they had a little sitting room. It wasn't big, but it was still a sitting room. This adds excitement to a master bedroom. Look at the windows, same as the secondary room on the size, but then you got 2 massive windows with a big massive door, right? Leading out to your front porch upstairs. So again, you still have the upstairs and this is fantastic. I like the wood, but I also like the floor tech style floors where it's got, you don't have to stain it all the time. It's much more durable, lasts a lot longer. They use them a lot of homes now. All right, master closet, nice size closet. This is a good size. And let's move on into the master bath. It's a little thin, it's a little skinny. I would say this is probably more of a con for me, only because I'm a huge shower guy. And I'll tell you what, like, let me close this so you guys get the full. This is tight. I can have my, see that? See my shoulder, like, it's tight. Probably not my favorite thing thus far. But I love the tile, love the window over the shower, love the glass frameless. Big soaker tub, so you do have that. I like the little built-in shelf, so you got things there. You do have the quartz counters in the master bathroom. You got nice poles, okay? The one thing that I was saying, when my wife and I brush our teeth in the morning, we kind of bump elbows because we're so close to one another. So you can see, this is relatively as close as we have. And with all the stuff that you have, you can kind of get in each other's way a little bit. Nothing to break up a marriage over, but just saying, it can be one of those things that causes a bit of turmoil in the house. All right, so I hope you guys really thoroughly enjoyed this floor plan. Again, this is the Jasper. This is 3 beds, 2.5 baths, 2,454 square feet. But if you want to know how much this home costs, you're gonna have to stick around, because next we're gonna go check out the Sinclair. And I think we're gonna like this one. So let's go see it. Also, let me say this. It is a beautiful day. It is mid-January, and let me tell you this. There's no wind. It's sunny. I mean, look at the sun. Look at that guy. He's way up there. Yeah, you see him? And I'm not freezing. And I got friends in Buffalo right now who are freezing, so I feel for you. All right, here is the Sinclair. So the Sinclair, as you can see, is 2839 square feet. Again, hardy plank siding, brick front, gutters, really nice stuff on this house. You got your big front porch. It's one of the things I definitely like. And look at the wide entranceway with the glass door. So we are in the Sinclair. The Sinclair is currently set up as a 3-bedroom plus a loft. This is, again, really nice tall 9-foot ceilings. This is a beautiful floor plan. Look at all the crown molding and everything they've done. So we got a full bathroom in here. Nice, good size, full bath. For a bedroom, as they have it set up as an office, but this would be a very large bedroom. This is actually bigger than the bedrooms that we saw in the last house. This is a big bedroom. Yeah, nice big closet over there. Now coming back down this way, we got the hallway. We have your laundry room, which leads out to your 2-car garage. And then we've got a formal dining room. If you don't want to use that bedroom, right, as an office, you can turn this into a office as well. You can put some doors on this. So as we enter, we've got this great open living space. Look how beautiful this is. They've done a great job decorating this home. One of the things I will say is this home shows you how beautiful this home really is. When they've got it decorated, it looks beautiful. Love all the lighting in here. I love how True Homes puts a lot of ceiling lights in. That way you have nice bright kitchens and space, open living spaces. So this is a pantry. So you got your little butler station, put coffee there. Love, love, love the counters. And again, this is not something you see with a lot of builders. This is usually a major upgrade. This stone has a little bit of speckle to it, but it has a really earthy, a lot of earth tones. Same with the backsplash, the cabinets, very earthy tones. Love all the space in the kitchen. All the window lighting just adds that bit of atmosphere. So this product has changed. So what they probably have done is they've moved away from the 2, the 4 window slider, okay? And they've probably gone to the 3-bay, which actually opens more than this, okay? I remember a while back during COVID, some of these sliders got discontinued and everybody was kind of up in arms about it. But now they have the big 3-space slider. So more than likely that's what True Homes has as a substitution. Love it because it does add that indoor-outdoor experience. Nice back patio. Again, we've got the LVP flooring. And you're probably thinking to yourself, Ryan, this house has got to cost close to half a million, maybe even upwards of 600,000. But I can assure you, it's not even that. Love, love, love the master. So again, folks, we are in True Homes Homecoming, and we are looking at their 4 models that they have here. Their 4 most popular models. If you're looking for a ranch product, definitely got this figured out. Huge, huge space here in the bedroom, master bedroom. Oh, yes, okay. This is what I'm talking about, people. Space on the countertop. Look at that, look at that. Boom. And they've got a little space for vanity, makeup. Love that. Love the shower. Okay, now this is a big shower, folks. Big, big shower. Well, look at that, what we got here. Love all the tile, the bench. So my wife will be happy. She can shave her legs. Apparently, that was something I never knew before. Apparently, I'm gonna have to build a bench in my bathroom, or my shower, excuse me. But look at this. Rain head shower. That's all I gotta say there. And you've got these great niches. You got light up there from the window. This is a big enough shower for a man. I don't know, I like it. I like this floor plan. I even like, look at this. I even like the tiles that they've chosen for this bathroom. You got your water closet and then nice big walk-in closet. This is the Sinclair. This is 2841 square feet. So it's actually bigger than the last house. Let's go upstairs, because this does have a decent upstairs. Now it's not a full upstairs. It's kind of, you'll see here once we get up, but you've got your loft. Look at this. Got your couch, your TV, media space. Maybe a good spot for game night. Huge game closet or storage closet. And then if you come in here, look at the size of this space. This is like another master. So essentially this would be like a frog finished room over garage. Holy, look at this closet. This is like a dual master situation here. Once off the bedroom, you've got your sink, your toilet, and your shower. So as I was saying, three bedrooms, plus a formal dining, plus a loft. I don't know about you guys, but I think this is a really awesome floor plan. 2841 square feet, it's a very healthy size, and high ceilings upstairs as well, just not downstairs. So you're probably thinking, Ryan, this house gotta cost 600K. It doesn't, but you're gonna have to stick around to the end where I tell you how you can save the most money and get the prices on here. So be sure to stick around. All right, off to the next one. All right, so we just left the Sinclair and we are headed into the Devon. This is a 2398 square foot home. Look at this. Beautiful front, love the elevation. Love the board and batten going down. So now we're in the Devon. This is a three bedroom, two and a half bath house. Again, keep in mind, all these homes can be customized. Maybe you wanna add another bedroom. You can certainly customize these homes. Love how open this home is. So I like right up there, you've got your kind of your formal dining room, which is open, and it's open to the kitchen. And if you are an electric person, you're like, hey Ryan, we don't like gas. I do have some people who are not gas fans, and that's okay. And again, those same doors, but I'm sure they've swapped them out with something as adequate. All right, so let's first check out this space over here. In here we got your laundry room. We got your two-car garage. So we are now in the master, great size master. Absolutely love it. Nice, decent sized bathroom. Sinks are close again, but you do still have that quartz counter. You got your toilet and your shower. And then nice big walk-in closet. So again, we are in the Devon. 2398 square feet, three beds, two and a half baths. And I'd say one of the things I'm really liking about the homes by True Homes is the openness, but it's defined openness. Like, it makes sense. There's a lot of homes you walk into, it's just an open space, got a granite countertop, and that's it. And it's like, well, where should I put the couch? Where should I put this? True Homes actually makes their homes make sense. So let's turn this around. Right up here at the top of the stairs is the big game room. Look at this, big loft space. Or study room. But it's got a nice pitched ceiling. So it feels big in here. Look at the size of these bedrooms. These bedrooms are huge, and they're secondary bedrooms. These are like some neighborhoods' masters. Another big, big secondary. These are twin mattresses. There's two twins in here, so you can kind of see how big it is. Now, one of the things I'll mention is if you're thinking about or you're interested in purchasing one of these homecoming True Homes houses, one of the things you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna get in touch with me or my team, because we work with these folks on pretty much a weekly, monthly basis. And why that's important for you is because our agents get special incentives. We get special rates on things. There's things that, like, if you were to just walk in to a neighborhood, well, they're probably not gonna tell you about all the real estate incentive benefits you would have had you walked through the door with a realtor. And that's kind of what I'm talking about. You really have to have someone on your side when working with the builders. No questions asked. People always are just like, well, I'll just go in there and it'll be fine. And it's sometimes not. And that's what you need to remember. So let's head over to the next house. And if you're wondering the price on this home, that's right, you guys got it by now. Wait till the end. You're gonna have to wait till the end, and I will give you all the pricing on these homes and more. So let's go and see our final home. Okay, so maybe you're a big family. Maybe 3 beds, 2.5 baths, just isn't gonna cut it for you. Maybe you got 4 or 5 kids, like me. Oh, I have so many. I'm just kidding, guys. This house behind me is 3,165 square feet, 5 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms. So almost everybody gets their own bathroom. Let's take a look at this. Again, I love the shaker on the house. I love the hardy plank siding. People don't realize, but that actually helps keep your house cool in the summer. Love the green door. So as we enter, got a nice little hall closet. We got our formal dining room off to the right hand side. Some nice wall features. And as we enter in, ooh, I love, love, love the straight wrought iron. Takes away from that like early 2000s knob ones that they used to have that you kind of see everywhere. This gives it a more modern feel. Now, look at this kitchen. So this is our, what I would call a gourmet style kitchen. Look at these cabinets. I mean, if you were buying a $1 million house, this is how much counter space you should have, or at least close to it. Now, this home is not $1 million. Let's preface that. But look at all the cabinet space. You got your 42s mixed with your 36 inch cabinets. You got some really great pulls. I love the backsplash, gives that marble feel. You've got your butler's pantry. So you got your coffee maker. If you're a wine gal, you can have some wine there. Again, nice big 42 inch cabinets underneath. And then look at this, huge pantry. So you got a nice, really good, decent sized pantry. As we enter the kitchen, you've got your commercial grade sink. You got your nice Moen head faucet. Absolutely love that. You got your 5 burner cooktop, 36 inch cooktop with your 36 inch range. One of the things I like that True Home does, you see this? Just this little extra molding, right? Makes all the difference in the world. Most builders don't put anything there. So it just like looks like it sits there with the space in between the ceiling and the cooktop. It looks a little silly to me. And that extra crown molding just kind of puts the cherry on it. You got your smart home system. So you got a air fryer, microwave, and then you got your full oven. Again, I like the detail, I like the two-tone on the cabinets. So you got that navel blue and the white. Look at this great living room. I love the fireplace. I like the little detail. I love how that separates the breakfast area from the living room. Love the 4 big windows right there. There's really not anything I'm seeing that I haven't like been wowed at. Do you know what I mean? Like, nice little back tour. And if you get a water view, that's kind of what it would look like. So again, we're in the Riley. Now let's leave the kitchen and the living room. Let's go through here. You've got a nice little drop zone coming in off the garage. Nice little closet right here. Your garage is there. Nice full bathroom down here again. And there's a full bedroom down here. Now, you know, if I was somebody and I got family, friends, anybody coming into town, this would make a great guest suite, okay? It's a good size, it's comfortable, it's got beautiful windows. Top of the stairs, again, absolutely love this wrought iron up and down the hallway. Adds a very classy look. First bedroom, good size. You got a nice walk-in closet with a window, so you can tell your dark blues and blacks in the morning. Okay, it's a little Jack and Jill action. So you got your toilet and shower in there, and you got your sink, dual vanity out here. So somebody in the morning from this room can be showering and using the toilet, and somebody from this room can be in here brushing their teeth. Best of all worlds. So again, good sized room here. Regular closet. All right, now we're coming. Wow, this house got a lot of different rooms. Now we're coming out of this bedroom, which has our laundry room up here attached. And I'll bet you this is the mechanical closet. Bingo. Guys, and this is even, I mean, you're not supposed to put stuff up here, but this is a little bit of extra storage space. All right, so this was bedrooms 2 and 3. And now we would have came down this long hallway here, right on into the master. Master bath. Oh yeah, love, love, love the tiled shower. Definitely gotta have a seat and the rainfall head. Absolutely love this shower and bathroom. Like the big tub, love the big window over the tub, that's even better. And then look at that nice little private water closet. You've got your walk-in closet. Holy God. Okay, so it starts here, right? And then look at this. Look at how much space that is. It goes all the way around. And then all the way over here. So you got all that space there plus over here. The only thing I'm gonna complain about in this one is how close the sinks are. So this is literally the same size sink that my wife and I have. This is what we deal with every morning. We do not have that big flower in the middle, but you know, between my razor, her stuff, her straightener, my stuff, it's basically essentially kind of, it's certainly tough for us to get ready in the morning. If you're gonna get ready in the morning together, you gotta know that is gonna be a little tight for you. So we have just finished seeing the fourth model here on Model Row at Homecoming by True Homes. Absolutely A plus all the way through. I think they've done a really great job with this neighborhood, and I even think it's gonna start exploding. Now that Summerville might be getting a little overcrowded for some people, this is a great alternative. I mean, you can come here, you can buy a home, have a little bit of space. Sure, it's a 15-minute ride to the grocery store, but that will change. They're building and putting infrastructure all around here. It's just not here now. But they've got their amenity center in, there's talks of another amenity center down the road, and there's even lots here as big as a half an acre. I'm blown away by it. And right now they've got one for sale that is 0.33 acres big. And that is a huge lot, sits on kind of a curve. So you got a massive backyard. You really, guys, you gotta reach out. Give me a call, days, nights, weekends, holidays. It doesn't matter. I'm your neighborhood expert. I will help you get and retain a home here in this neighborhood and work only with their best salespeople. Ryan McHugh, your neighborhood expert, 843-226-5535. Now, let's jump back into the studio where we're gonna talk about prices. Cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching. Everybody's favorite topic. So let's go. Hey guys, welcome back to the show and welcome back to the studio. Now, I hope you're enjoying my tour out in the field at True Homes Homecoming in Ravenel, South Carolina. Now, I want to go over some of the prices because I was teasing you the whole video and saying,
hey, you got to stick around to the end because I got the pricing.
So let's talk about the first home we saw. All right, the Jasper. That was coming in at 2454 square feet. That was 3 bedrooms, 2.5 baths. But fully customizable, okay? So the model home we saw, I'm gonna give you the exact price of that home. So a lot of builders don't do this. A lot of builders don't give you the exact price of what their model is. They just say, this is the base price. And you know, if you do $60,000 in options, you can build this home. So what I'm gonna actually do is give you the exact breakdown of each model that we saw. So starting off with the Jasper, that was that great floor plan. It had the huge island, had the big great room. My clients have purchased this home in the past. It's a really, really great home. And in fact, I can tell you that they definitely did not pay this price for that home, but that's okay because every home is a little bit different. If you get one spec'd out by the builders, you're probably not gonna, it's not gonna be as high as you think it would be. And the reason for that is a lot of incentives, a lot of things go on with the builder that I can help you with in the background that not a whole lot of people see. So the base price of that Jasper is $435,440. The lot premium is gonna be around $10,000, so that's the lot that you're gonna purchase. Now, if you want one of those big 0.33 half acre lots, you're gonna be looking more to the $20,000 to $30,000 lot premium. All right. Elevation, that's the front of the home. That's how the front of the home looks. That particular elevation, that home that we are seeing, that elevation is $13,400, okay? Now, the other thing is structural options. So structural options are like fireplaces, screen porches, things that are actual structural that they need to have done that aren't design options, right? That was another $15,575. Showroom options, which are your design center options, like handles, cabinets, granite, quartz, all that kind of stuff, was $41,433 in that model home that we saw. Now, total sales price, the entire sales price, out the door price, is $515,848. That's right, $515,848. Now, if you're someone that's saying, well, Ryan, that's over $500,000 for a 3-bed, 2.5-bath, but look at all the things they crammed into that home. They had semi-custom pretty much everything. So keep that in mind. If you're looking for that more semi-custom approach, it's going to be a little bit higher in the high fours, low fives. So now let's talk about the next home we saw, home number two, the Sinclair. That came in at 2841 square feet, 3 bedrooms, 3 full baths, which is amazing. That was the single story floor plan that we saw that had everything. I mean, that was a really great floor plan. If you're someone who's like, hey, I like the idea of all first floor living, but I've got adult kids, I got family who's gonna come visit me, then the Sinclair is gonna be an amazing floor plan for you. All first floor living, you've got that amazing walk-in closet, master bathroom, master owner suite with the little bit of a bump out there, that extended room, which I absolutely love. And then you've got your 2 bedrooms down. So you've got another bedroom down, you've got your formal dining, you've got your flex office space, which you need. And then it goes on to the upstairs. Now, the upstairs of this home was the loft and the extra bedroom. So the base price of this home was $456,860. The lot premium was $10,000. The elevation was $14,100, and structural options, and again, structural options are things like those sliding glass doors that we saw, a fireplace, the room upstairs, that's all of your structural items that came in at $18,240. Now, they went a little crazy in the showroom, but that's okay, because they ended up spending just under $40,000 in the showroom, which you might be seeing, Ryan, that's really excessive on top of the structural options, showroom options. Yeah, but that home was decked
out with everything. And I actually like that home. First floor living is kind of an ideal idea when you start getting into your 40s. This particular total purchase price of this home was $538,250. So if you want to replicate this home today, it's going to cost you $538,250. So again, you can replicate the Sinclair for you and your family if you so choose. So moving on to home number three, the Devon. So let's talk about the Devon. That was the 3-bed, 2.5 bath, right at 2,398 square feet, so almost 2,400. You had that amazing downstairs, very open concept. You had your owner suite right off of the great room. You had a nice 2-car garage. You also had that patio there. And then upstairs, you had your furnished bonus room. You had your 2 bedrooms upstairs. And to be honest with you, that's a really, really, really great space upstairs. If you're somebody who's like, hey, you know what? We got three kids. We need their spaces. You've got your owner suite, plus you got your 2 bedrooms upstairs. So you get a little separation. But the base price of this home, the Devon, is listed at $416,900. Okay, so $416,900, right at $417,000, instead we call it $417,000. Lot premium was $10,000. Elevation was only $5,900. But check this, structural options were almost $27,000. Okay, now your structural options, as I mentioned, sliding glass doors. Maybe you want that those spaces upstairs to be a little bit more defined. Maybe you want the finished bonus room. Maybe you don't. Maybe you want it unfinished. These are all things that play into the structural options price point. And then you have your design center showroom options. And listen to this. Those came out at $6,123. So you might be sitting here like, Ryan, did they not upgrade this house at all? No, they did. They just put all of their money, the important stuff, into structural options and left the designer stuff kind of, hey, you know what? We'll pick out the things we like. But at the end of the day, you know, if we want to add design stuff, we can do it after we move in. And some people do that, and that's a really great idea. So the total purchase price on that home was $465,568. Not a bad price for a nice 3-bedroom, 2.5 bath home. Now, moving on to our final floor plan. And boy, am I excited to talk about this one. The Riley, that was such a great floor plan. The Riley comes in at 3,165 square feet. This has got a whopping 5 bedrooms, 4 baths, okay? This model home was base priced at $485,800, okay? So $485,000. Lot premium was $10,000. So again, if you're gonna be somebody who's like, hey, I want a third of an acre, I want a half an acre, you're gonna need to pay a little bit higher lot premium. And the lot premiums aren't awful. Half an acre is like $30,000. So if you're going from, you know, 0.18 up to a half an acre, that might be a justifiable cost difference for you. The elevation on this home was only $3,800, and this was a nice elevation. The structural options, wait till you get this, structural options on that home were $36,526. So they went hard on some structural options, which is great. I'm totally for it. If you're somebody who's like, hey, we wanna make sure we have all the things we need in the home, the screen porch, the fireplace, you know, like all that good stuff, you will have that with those structural options. So if you're replicating this house, $36,526 in structural options. And get this, showroom options, right? Now, don't fall out of your chair, $64,180. But that was because this home was decked out with everything. It was so beautiful in there. The crown molding, the wrought iron. I mean, it made you feel like the Jack and Jill bathrooms. It just made you feel really at home. And it was a spacious home. So if you got more than 4 or 5 kids, you're definitely gonna want that space. You're gonna need that space. Showroom options, structural options, all together. Now, I think I said to you, some people are gonna say, Ryan, this is a million dollar house, or 800,000. It's not. This home comes in with all of the things considered, all the add-ons, starts at 485, everything considered. This home comes in at 600,000, guys. 600,000. Could you imagine that? Could you imagine having a 5-bedroom home with 4 full baths plus a massive loft? I mean, that's even better. And you've got 5 full bedrooms on top of getting a decent sized lot. I mean, that's amazing. So if you're thinking about relocating to Summerville and you're just like, maybe Summerville's getting a little too crowded, maybe I wanna be a little bit more off the beaten path, but I still want a beautiful house built, Homecoming is gonna be that neighborhood. And not to mention, you're zoned for DD2, so it's that much better. The cost, the neighborhood, the aesthetics, what you get from True Homes, I think is all justified by these prices. Now, if I've talked to you anything about any of these properties, maybe you've said, hey, Ryan, you know, 400, 450 is just way out of our budget. That's okay. True Homes has home prices and home floor plans in here that start at 374, and that's for about 1800 square feet. So if you're somebody, it's like, I don't know if I can spend $500,000. That's okay. They have options for you. They even have some spec options coming down the road. So you don't have to build one of these things from scratch. If you need a home quickly, we can get that for you. But just keep in mind, if you are going to be doing the necessary true to be built option, right? If you're going to do the typical true to be built option, then you're going to be looking at these base prices and then add on another $50,000, $60,000, $70,000 in add-ons just to know where you're going to be in price. So, you know, they've got owner suite downs, they have ranch plans, they have two-story plans. Their Milo floor plan, that is a 3-bed, 2.5-bath home, and that is right at $374,900. You've got to remember, these homes start at these prices, so once you go to design center and you add things on, they're going to go up in price, but at least you're seeing where they start. And I've got the whole list, so if you're interested in seeing the rest of what floor plans cost and what this list looks like, you got to give me a call. You got to reach out. 843-226-5535. Do you want to see available properties now in Homecoming? Then you got to go to my website, www.buyfromrye.com. And I look forward to seeing you guys next time. Be sure to let me know what you liked and what you didn't like. Leave some comments below and be sure to smash that like button and hit that subscribe button so you catch all my upcoming videos of all the different neighborhoods. Once again, Ryan McHugh, your neighborhood expert. I'll see you guys next time.